Hey guys, welcome to this session by Intellipaat. Now, you guys must have come across the term machine learning and you must be wondering what exactly it is. So in today's session, we'll be covering just that so that you can start your journey in the field of machine learning. So we'll understand the concepts of machine learning with this little example over here. So what do you see over here? What is it exactly? It's a car, isn't it? And how about this? Well, this again is a car. And this? Well, this too is a car. Now, how do you know all of these are cars? Well, as a kid, you might have come across a picture of a car and you would have been told by your kindergarten teacher or your parents that this is a car. And your brain learned that anything which looks like that is a car. And that is how our brain functions. But what about a machine? Now, if I take this image of a car and feed it to a machine, will it be able to identify that it's a car? So this is where machine learning comes in. So what I'll do is, I'll take all of these images of a car and keep on feeding them to the machine until it learns all the features associated with this car. And once it learns all the features associated with this car, I will give it new data or the test data to determine how well it has learned. Or in other words, first, I'll feed the machine training data so that it can extract all the features from the training data. And once the training is done, I will give it test data to determine how well the learning has been done. And this is the underlying concept of machine learning. So now that we've understood what exactly is machine learning, let's have a look at the categories of machine learning. So machine learning can be divided into supervised learning and unsupervised learning. So let's start with supervised learning. So in supervised learning, we have input variables and output variables. And these input variables are denoted with X and the output variables are denoted with Y. And we try to understand how does Y vary with X. Or in other words, we have dependent variable and independent variables. And we try to determine how does a dependent variable change with respect to these independent variables. Now again, the supervised learning can be divided into regression and classification. So let's start with classification. So in classification, the output variable is of categorical in nature. So let's take this example to understand it better. So over here, we have gender of the student and the result of the student. So gender is the independent variable and result is the dependent variable. And we are trying to determine whether the student will pass the exam or not on the basis of the gender of the student. Or in other words, we are basically trying to classify the data. So next, we have regression. So in regression, the output variable is a continuous numerical. So let's take this example. So over here, we are trying to predict the prices of Apple, which is basically a continuous numerical. So guys, this is how supervised learning algorithms work. Next, we'll head on to unsupervised learning. So in unsupervised learning, we have input data with no class labels. And we try to build a model to understand the underlying structure of the data. So let's take this example over here. So we have this input data with no class labels and this input data comprises of fish and birds. Now I'll take this input data and I'll build an unsupervised learning model on top of this input data. So this will give me two clusters. So the first cluster comprises of all the fish and the second cluster comprises of all the birds. Now you guys need to keep in mind that even though there were no class labels, this unsupervised learning model was able to divide this data into two clusters. And this clustering has been done on the basis of similarity of characteristics. So in the first cluster, all of the values are similar. All of them are fish. And the second cluster, all of the values are similar. So this time, all of them are birds. So this is how an unsupervised learning model works. So guys, this was a brief intro to machine learning. And do stay tuned to Intellipaat's YouTube channel for more such informative videos.